Today we got another front mount intercooler, and this one's going on the gray GTI. Can you see it? This one's going on the gray GTI. If you haven't seen the video of me installing the intercooler on my car, it's just literally the same exact one. It's going on this car. He's officially stage 2 now. I forgot what tune he went with, but he's stage 2 now. So we're going to install this intercooler.
Yo, shut the fuck up.
So this intercooler comes with all the piping, all the clamps and shit you're gonna need, and the brackets. This one brackets up right to the front, so like it's really easy to install. Then the actual intercooler. So we're gonna leave this in the box so I don't damage it, but it's a pretty big beefy intercooler. If you go with the easiest tuning one, you're for sure not like skimping out or anything. It is a very nice intercooler. Let me show you how it looks on my car. It looks pretty sick, like under the bumper, behind the bumper. My car still has no turbo though, so. Mine will be coming off pretty soon, because if you saw on the part 3 of why my turbo blew up, you probably saw that there was some metal in the boost pipes. So we're gonna take them off, we're gonna clean them. I'm so pale right now. We're gonna take off the boost pipes, we're gonna clean the boost pipes, and then we're gonna clean the inside of the intercooler. I don't know exactly how to do that, but we're gonna do that in part 4 of the turbo series of videos for this car, I guess. We're also gonna drop the oil pan when we do that, so that's gonna come next week. This week I've been lazy. I just a little bit depressed about my turbo, but depending on what happens today or tomorrow, we might have a whole completely different turbo setup. So today is the day the turbo is supposed to arrive at the inspector, the one that failed. You know what they say and what ends up happening with that company will kind of like guide the way I'm gonna go in terms of what turbo I'm gonna get next. I honestly don't want to get another IS38 through them anymore, but you guys have recommended a lot of options in the comments, and one of the biggest one is the Vortex, the EQT Vortex turbos. They have a standard turbo, they have an XL turbo, and I've been looking at them and they seem dope as fuck. Any of you guys that know anything about those, to comment down below and let me know what I need, exactly like what I need to get. I know I need to get the turbo, I need to get a cob tuner through them and a tune through them, but what else should I get? What else should I get? Obviously, I don't want to spend too much money, so anything just to get me started, just to get me going. So like I'm guessing a high pressure fuel pump, that's one thing. I don't think I want to tune for E85 yet, and I don't think I'm gonna go different injectors yet, just because I don't have the funds for that, guys. Like yeah, I don't know. So you just let me know what I need to just to get started, just to get the turbo on, and just to make, you know, decent power just to begin with. Put that in the comments below. Tell me what you recommend. Tell me what you guys think I should do. You could also go and DM me on Instagram and then let me know on there too. Okay, so this is super easy install. So literally taking off the bumper, taking off the old hoses, taking off some plastic, like, I don't know what it's called. Not trim, but some plastic things that are in the front. You basically just take them off, and some plastic off the bumper that's inside. And then put your new brackets on and all your new stuff. So let's just do it.
You need a catch can. All this goes straight into your motor.
Oh, easy.
Nice. I had to drill it out a little bit so it could actually fit, because that bolt holds up this whole stuff right here, whatever. I don't know actually what it does, but it seems like it's pretty important right here. So just drilled it out so I could actually fit it. This piping is pretty sick. It's nice and thick compared to what you get with, like, compared to what comes on the car. I'm surprised. I'd be surprised if you ever get like a boost leak from one of these, cause like they're hefty, man. They're on there, and then the clamps they give you are pretty. They're pretty nice too. Way better than SOG.
I'm just putting it back together quick. This should be fast. I realized from actually editing this video that I never actually showed you guys how it looks on the car. So here y'all go. Nah, you can't even see it. Let me move the car. Stay here. Man, you can still barely see it. I mean, it's there for sure. Like, you can see it, but. Yeah, it looks pretty sick, I'm not gonna lie. I was thinking, he wants to do it too, but we were thinking of just taking these things off, the grill part off of our actual bumpers. Just so it'll look cooler, I guess. I think mine is more visible just because of the red compared. But yeah, that's how it looks. So thank you guys for watching. It's been like a week since I actually put that on, and I just haven't edited the video. I'm barely doing it now, but I still haven't heard anything about this turbo or if I'm getting a new one or whatever is going on. So hopefully we get to drive it soon, but it's still here. Like, comment, subscribe, and stay tuned for this stuff, turbo stuff on this car. Also, that car is getting a new clutch. We're gonna do that pretty soon. So, and I think he's getting upgraded like brake pads or whatever. So we'll do that. We'll throw that in a vlog or something. So go watch that.